Hi, Jeff Garraux with ESAB. In this video, we're going to be overviewing the Aristo family of power supplies and feeders. The main thing with the Aristos when we're looking at applications is advanced processes, different materials, whether it be carbon steel, stainless, or aluminum, and when we need to get into pulse MIG and other applications. Also, limits and locks start to come into play with these style power supplies. The two main feeders that we offer with this family are the U6 and the U82, and it still does an excellent job just like the Warrior family with the gouging performance. To demonstrate the capabilities of this equipment, we're going to do live demos of pulse MIG welding and gouging. When we're looking at competitive equipment compared to the Aristo platform, we have two clear ways of going about it. The U6, simple to use with high performance, or the UA2 with advanced controls and all the options we need to tackle anything out in the field. When it comes to arc performance, it's relatively a level playing field. The big difference is what the controllers give us to the end user. The other nice thing is if we do have a wire or gas that is not available readily, we can create a synergic line custom to that end user. When it comes to arc performance, we're heads up comparable to the competition. The Aristo platform meets or exceeds the competitive arc performance, where we really have a big differentiator as the U82 control, where we can custom make synergic lines. So in the Aristo family, we have two main power supplies. We have the Aristo 500iX and the Aristo U5000i. They both have the same output, 60% duty cycle of 500 amps. The biggest differences are the ability to interface with robot systems and having high frequency DC TIG. Both of those options are available in the U5000i, while the 500iX is more on the basic end. The reasons to pick the Aristo U5000i over the Aristo 500iX is connectivity through weld cloud, the ability to hook up to robots, and the ability to run high frequency DC TIG. If you do have an Aristo 500iX and you wish to connect it to weld cloud, you can use the universal connector. The two main reasons that an end user would go up to a Aristo from a Warrior package would be pulse MIG welding and the ability to use limits and locks. Some of our end users find themselves in need of pulse MIG, whether it be a requirement for a code that they're working on, or maybe they need better control when welding thin materials. Also, some end users use pulse at higher currents because it's easier to train welders to listen for a specific sound. The system is also very adaptive in comparison to CV MIG welding, so therefore there's less chances for spatter once the arc is tuned in. Some of the main reasons why we're looking to reduce or eliminate spatter in the welding process is, first off, it's basically wire that you paid for that didn't actually end up in the final weld. On top of that, it's an extra process to clean off the material for post-weld inspection and also paint. If spatter is an issue at your shop, you might want to look into the Aristo pulse systems. Another reason to use the Aristo platform is limits and locks. This is where we can take the existing weld procedure and assign it to the memory to make sure the welders stay within procedure. One of the main drivers from the end user to do this is because they want to stay within a WPS on the limits and locks side, or they want to just lock out the controller altogether to make sure their welders are staying busy instead of messing with the controller. In the Aristo family, it does depend on which controller we have and how much we can limit the user from having access to. On the robust feed U6, we have two settings, fully unlocked or welder mode. Welder mode, they can only access the memories that we have saved and made available to them. On the Aristo U82, we have much more control over how far we can allow the user to go in. The robust feed U82 has more advanced levels of lockout than the U6. It actually has four levels. It still has a welder level and an admin level. The welder level, just access to already pre-saved memories. Admin level, full access. And we have two other levels of security that give us access to different parts of the controller. When we get to the Aristo family, we have two main feeder options that we can put on the system. The robust feed U6 and the robust feed U82. There's a lot of similarities between these two feeders. They both have pulse MIG, they both have limits and locks. The U6 is a little bit more inviting of a panel. It's a little easier, a lot less menus. The U6 has 10 memories and over 90 synergic lines covering everything from carbon steel wires, metal core wires, stainless steel, and aluminum. On the more advanced U82, we have 255 memories and over 290 synergic lines. Once again, encompassing all different types of wires like carbon steel, stainless steel, metal core wires, and aluminum. The robust feed U82 is the perfect option for those that need plenty of memories, limits and locks, and a whole library of synergic lines. The Aristo family has the same great performance in gouging as the Warrior family. The bonus is, with the U8 and the U6, I can control the process changeover right at the feeder, and I can also hook the torch to the back of the feeder, utilizing the same cable set that is running the feeder. Here we're demonstrating how the robust feed U6 gives us the versatility to go from welding to gouging. Now this is crucial for certain applications like full penetration welds. The Aristo family has the same great gouging performance as the Warriors. The added benefit of using the Aristo system for gouging is we have the same process control at the front of the feeder. We don't have to go back to the power supply to change over, and we can still hook the torch to the back of the feeder utilizing the cable set instead of running a separate cable. When ordering an Aristo package, you get the power supply, feeder, 5-foot cable set, cart, work clamp, and of course, a genuine Tweco MIG gun. There's a lot of different options and accessories that we need to take into consideration when ordering your Aristo package. First off, all of the feeders come standard with 035-045 V-groove drive rolls, which is basically for solid wires. So if you're gonna be running cord wires or a different diameter than that, you're gonna need to order those drive rolls. On top of that, if you plan on utilizing the excellent carbon arc gouging performance of the machine, we need to get you into an arc air gouging torch. Also, if you're going to be running stick electrodes, you'll need the holder for that as well. The Aristo family of power supplies has the same casework as the Warrior, so it carries the same IP rating, IP23. In the Aristo family, the power blocks are slightly different, but you will not see any difference in arc performance from one machine to the other. Another nice thing about the Aristo 500iX is it's actually the same platform as the Warrior, and it's been upgraded to handle the advanced processes and communication to our advanced feeders. So through that, we have all the rugged reliability and field testing that we've already done with the Warrior right into the 500iX package.